Now class 4th A. Class 4th A. GSC subject is GSC and date 4/10/4/11/2020 and today we are going to start revision lesson 10 our clothes lesson 10 our clothes In this lesson our clothes we have to study about our clothes man has always been inventing things to make the life comfortable it happens with clothes too early human had got the idea of weaving clothes by observing spider webs and bird nests we learn from the nature early man saw the spiders and their the webs and nests and birds some beavers birds are there and they make their the nest man developed plants that could give him fiber hair of different animals to wear used as the fibers today scientists have developed many kinds of fibers cotton wool silk nylon rayon and the polyester are some of the cheap fibers used for making clothes types of fibers so in case of the fibers types of fibers are there two types number one is natural and other is artificial or man made first one the natural fibers one is natural fibers and second is man made or synthetic fibers synthetic or man made fibers so two type fibers are there natural fibers and synthetic are the man made fibers natural fibers obtained from the natural sources like plants and animals while synthetic fibers are made by human beings by chemical substances the examples of the natural fibers cotton jute coir are some fibers which are obtained by the are obtained from different types of the plants in the same way wool silk are the fibers obtained from different animals so we get the fibers from both plants and animals next one synthetic fibers synthetic fibers are obtained from chemical substances nylon rayon polyester and acrylic or some synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers are stronger than cotton, wool or silk. So synthetic fibers are stronger than cotton, woolen or silk fibers. Clothes made from synthetic fibers are more durable and attractive. But synthetic fibers do not absorb sweat and can catch fire very easily. This is the drawback of the synthetic fibers. What drawbacks are there? One is they do not absorb sweats and can catch fire easily. So synthetic clothes may not be used in the kitchen. Next fiber, to fibric, fiber to fibric. Fibers are spun into threads and yarns. Threads or yarns are woven into fabrics. Fabric is used to make clothes. Fabrics are used to make the clothes. So clothes are our basic need. Clothes are our basic need. They give us appearance. They protect us from dust, dirt, sun and cold. We wear different clothes in different seasons. So in summer, we wear cotton clothes because we sweat heavily in this season. A huge amount of the sweat is generated in the summer season. So people prefer to wear the cotton clothes. Cotton clothes are comfortable in all the seasons. So in summer we wear cotton clothes because we sweat heavily in this season. Cotton clothes do not absorb the heat of the sun. They keep the body cool by allowing free flow of air. Next, in winter, we wear woolen clothes. In winter, we wear woolen clothes because they keep off the cold. They protect us from the cold. How they keep us warm? They keep us warm. Wool has hair and so air can stay between them. This air acts in two ways. First, it does not let the heat of the body to go out, means to prevent the escape of the heat from out the body. Another, at the same time, it does not let the outer cold get in. Now, in rainy season, we go out during rains. In rainy season, we go out during rains. We wear raincoats, which are made up of waterproof clothes. During rainy season, we use the raincoats. Raincoat is also made up of the waterproof clothes. We also use umbrellas and gumboots. We use umbrellas and gumboots that do not allow the water to seep through. And clothes protect us from dust. The air has dust particles that stick to clothes and make them dirty. Clothes do not let the dust settle on our the body. Clothes also protect us from insect bites. long sleeved clothes during rainy and the summer season save us from the mosquito bites. So the clothes protect us from the dust. They also protect us from the mosquito bites. And one important thing is there, clothes make us smart. We wear different colorful dresses on special occasions like wedding and the parties. Different type of the clothes we wear at different occasions. Specific uniforms. Professionals are recognized by their uniforms. They have some special uniform. You have seen the policemen have a special uniform. Doctors have a special uniform. Nurses have a special uniform. Pilots have a special uniform. They have some special type of uniform, that is specific. Means the uniform is specific for the doctors, is specific for the nurses, is specific for the policemen, etc., etc. So these special uniforms are the specific for different professionals. You also wear the uniform, and different schools have specific uniforms. So in many professions, people wear specific uniforms. People wear different clothes according to the jobs they do. Doctors, nurses, policemen, soldiers, lawyers, pilots, etc. wear special uniform at work. Students also wear school uniform. Now, care of the clothes. Clothes are the necessary part of our life. So we should take care of them. Proper care of clothing makes it last longer. Number one, cotton clothes. Sari clothes should be washed properly with a good detergent. Colored clothes must be washed and dried separately inside. White clothes must be dried in sun. Generally, silken and woolen clothes are destroyed by insects if not cared for. So steps must be taken to protect them from insects. Naphthalene balls are dried leaves of the neem. Neem tree can keep the insect away from our clothes. Now next point. Fine quality silk clothes and woolen clothes require dry cleaning. They are spoiled by wet washing. Next point, always use hangers to keep ironed clothes in the wardrobe. Next point, minor damages such as broken buttons or tears should be mended on time. Thank you, that's for today.